This P-51 was built during the latter part of the war and was purchased by Charles Lyford of Seattle as war surplus. Lyford, who hungers for action, likes to race hydroplanes when he's not flying. And who could ask for a better sport plane than this 437-mile-an-hour fighter?
could see the white Bardahl Special in race three with Stephen Couches. And you could see he's able to jump out in front. But don't forget, he can't turn in front until he gets to that guide pylon, which is right here. Definitely recognized white Bardahl Special. The Bardahl has such a history here at Reno over the years, over the 58, nearly six decades of racing. And our late friend Steve Stavrakakis used to say, these are the bad boys of speed, and here you're going to see why. Race three, Bardahl Special demonstrating it coming right down the valley of speed. Followed by race six here in second place. Those two are kind of separating themselves from the rest of the pack.
Out front, as he has been through this entire race. He still has John Dusty Dow Jr. starting the number one position. Hanging with him as best he can right now to really get up close. Nary a wobble, not a misstep at all. He has seemingly flown the perfect race here.
It looks to me like Stephen Couches has found something in this class, Tommy, even though he qualified a couple of miles an hour slower than the competition. He's got something tuned up today. You see him drop down to that 5 foot minimum altitude, trying to make the most that he's got. He's got to make those last few 7, 8, 9 mile turns and hope for the checkered flag.